Hi, my name is Mark Poulton. I'm a real estate investor in the greater Charlotte, North Carolina area. What you would call a no frills, no thrills real estate investor. If you're looking for someone with a shiny sports car in the back or nice studio office or maybe even someone who's trying to sell you $19.95 a month subscription to their newsletter, I'm not that guy. Check out a different channel. I'm on the first story roof at my very first rental property. We're actually putting up siding and trying to get all the J channel working before we can actually get the actual siding itself up. And I think we had just gone through the second paycheck of the government furlough, partial government shutdown. It's all really a bunch of BS. I mean, we're talking like less than 20% of the actual government workforce. And with President Trump calling back the IRS, it's probably even less than that now. And it got me thinking about, becoming unfurloughable, or you can say it a different way, unfireable. So I remember my big mouth has gotten me in a lot of trouble over the years, and my somewhat gruff demeanor. I don't always play nice with other people, and think I'm above average intelligence. I'm very good at what I do in computers, and I have a little patience for incompetence. No, people who don't even know they're incompetent. I mean, if you come up and you're like, "Hey, listen, I don't know much about this," that's fine, but don't sit there and act like you do, and we'll be fine. It's the guys that act like they know what they're doing and they're experts, and you come to find out they don't know anything, that drive me nuts. And I'm okay with ignorance, but you need to know that you're ignorant and not come across as some expert. So one of the reasons I do this job, and believe me, I put a lot of time and effort into it, is so that nobody can take my paycheck away from me. Nobody can take my income away from me, except for myself. That doesn't mean like the FBI, the IRS, or CIA or whatever, NSA can't come and arrest me and seize all my assets. This is very different. But I'm just talking about on a regular basis. The big tech company that I work for, my day job, they could come up to me and be like, "Hey, you're fired," and I'm losing a large chunk of income. And that's why we're working to replace that income. And that's what you need to do as well. If you're looking for financial freedom, you're not going to do it working a W-2 job. There's no more trading 20 years of your life for a pension and a promise of a paycheck for the rest of your life. I mean, look at Sears Holdings. Just watched a video on it. They paid $2 billion in the last, I think, 2 years. And $5 billion over like the last 6 years or 10 years into the pension program. And that's money that they could not use towards innovation and making themselves more relevant. And because of that, or at least, you could say that that's a leading factor to it. You have all these Sears pension holders that are probably going to have to go into the national pension program, which, Sears has been around for a very, very long time. I don't want my retirement dependent upon a company that's could go out of business like Sears. I mean, 20 years ago or 30 years ago, if you said Sears was going to go out of business, people would look at you like you're crazy. Con Edison, I think, is the electric company in California. They're about to file for bankruptcy because of all the wildfires that they may have potentially started. These are very old companies that have lots of retirees. I'm a conservative, and if I post conservative material online that my big tech company doesn't like, and they're not conservative at all, I can easily just lose my job. Somebody can decide, "Hey, listen, we want to target Mark Poulton, and we want to take him out because he said something that I disagree with." I don't like it when my big mouth gets in the way of me getting a paycheck. So I'm going to make it to where my big mouth doesn't get into the way of me making a paycheck, and that's one reason why I do this business. So, in conclusion, if you're dependent upon a W-2 job and you're dependent upon somebody else to give you a paycheck and you're depending upon Social Security even for retirement, much less some kind of pension program, you may want to rethink that. This isn't the 1950s and 40s where that was kind of a guarantee. It's 2019. Government workers who didn't prepare, and we hear all these sob stories of, "I can't make my mortgage payment." Financial institutions are bending over backwards for these people. I bank at USAA. They'll give you payday advance loans for probably nothing until your guaranteed paycheck comes in, even though you didn't work for the last 2 months or whatever it is. Anyways, you need to, my suggestion for financial freedom is you need to be unfurloughable. You need to be unfireable. I guess my wife leaving me in a divorce would cut into that a little bit, but I would still have an income. So anyways, I hope you go out there and live the You Won't Stop Me lifestyle. I can tell you right now, it's about 49 degrees. It's pretty cold, but it's not going to stop me from getting this siding up, and it's not going to stop me from getting this home rented out for about $1,400 to $1,500 a month. Anyways, I wish you luck.